I've got John Wendell here, and he's in charge of content directing, and which sort of art and audio, correct?
That's right.
All right, well, dive deep into the vehicle, talk about the graphics, the engine. What do you have for me?
Sure. Well, this time with Forza 3, we've really upped the ante with graphics this time around. Forza 2 ran at 60 frames a second. We're running at 60 frames a second again, but this time with an incredible level of detail. The car models this time in Forza 3, they have 10 times the polygons that we had in Forza 2, 4 times the texture resolution. What that means is you're going to see every little detail and nuance that's in this beautiful car, like the little keyhole there by the hood, the valve stems, the little windshield wiper sprayers. Every little thing is created to exact specificity of this car to look real. It supports kind of the car passion that people have for these and get in and geek out over every little detail in the car.
So as far as you guys have, is it roughly a 2-year development cycle between?
Yeah, two and a half years.
So what's changed as far as graphics and engine technology that's available that allows you to do this here that didn't allow you to do in Forza 2?
Well, really, why we're able to get so much more power out of the box is because we know the box better. When we released Forza 2, it was our first time out on the 360. We were really just kind of coming to terms with it. We had to rewrite a lot of the stuff from the ground up to work on the 360 from Xbox One. Now, this is our second time out on it, we're kind of riding to the metal, as they say. We're really getting the true power out of the 360. Typically, in a console life cycle, it takes 3 to 5 years for the developers really to figure out the box, really start to pump it for all the power that it has and start to get the true power out of the box. So we're able to just, with optimized rendering routines and a brand new rendering engine for the game, we're able to just get an incredible level of detail still running at 60 frames a second.
So do you use a particular rendering engine, or is it one that Turn
10 builds everything from the ground up. Yeah, we built this ourselves, it evolved, and then we rewrote it again for Forza 3 this time around.
And do you hope to use it in other games also?
We hope so. I mean, obviously we want to leverage everything we can, but we don't think about that right now. This is all about making Forza 3 as good as it can. So we don't want to compromise Forza 3 any way to make feature decisions that might affect games down the road. We want Forza 3 to be as good as it can. And then if future games need to use this or leverage it, we'll modify it then.
So what's the toughest thing about developing for a video game?
Well, for Forza 3 in particular, it's challenging just because of the sheer amount of content. We have over 400 cars in Forza 3 built to this level of detail with hundreds of thousands of polygons, huge textures. We have to go out and source each of these cars. We take photos, video of them. We record them on a dyno for their audio. We've even bought cars and crashed them to record the crash audio for the cars as well, so that the cars sound real when they're crashing into something. Then we have to build them all. We build interiors, the outsides. We build customizable parts for each one of them. We do full damage simulation on each one of them as well. Times 400 cars, it turns into hundreds of man years worth of work. With our art team at its peak was about 250 people all over the world building cars for Forza at any one point.
So talk a little bit about visible tire deformation.
It's really cool. It's a new feature for Forza 3. Our physics have always simulated tire deformation, which is the forces that a tire experiences when you go through a corner. Like, so when you're cornering hard and the tire rolls over, especially like if you think about an old classic muscle car with a tall sidewall tire, and you go through a corner, you can see that thing kind of rolling over like it's going to pop off the rim or something like that. Our physics have always simulated that, but visually you didn't get any representation of it. Now, again, with the new graphics engine, we're able to actually model this in real time, and you'll see a car as it goes through a corner, the tire rolling under, you can see it through the telemetry. When it goes to slow down, you know, it bulges out at the bottom, things like that. It's really cool. We're really excited about it. We're doing things in our physics that no other game can touch.
Now, I know some racing games I play, and I feel like the rollover is a really easy feature, and all cars roll over the same. Is there any difference in the vehicles rolling over?
The only differences between vehicles rolling over are just like in reality. Like this Ford GT with its wide wheelbase, low center of mass is going to be much tougher to roll over than, let's say, an SUV that tends to have a very high center of mass. Because everything's modeled very accurately to reality, a car will roll over as easy in our game as it would in reality, and this car consequently wouldn't roll over as easy as another.
Now, Forza also has a really good sort of community history, especially with user-generated content. What are we looking at as far as the editor and stuff goes?
Well, in the past, with Forza 2, you've seen our community do some crazy stuff. This time, we're really celebrating that. Not only are we providing them with more tools to empower these guys to make cooler paint jobs, tuning. We've added features like the WMV editor now so they can create videos of our replay footage. But now through some of the storefront features, we actually have the ability for these guys to be celebrated and become heroes in our community. Whereas before, it was kind of hard to find their content out there. You'd have to kind of dig for it. Now, we have leaderboards for paint jobs, for videos, for tuning setups. So these guys will naturally, through a voting system online, like on, kind of on YouTube, will naturally rise to the top, and it'll be easy for them to kind of be recognized, but it'll also be easy for us to go out there and find the best content. So you don't have to sift through 1,000 paint jobs of Hello Kitty to find the one that's really cool. You can actually go out and just find the top rated content at any time and just check in every week and just see who's got the cool stuff coming out.
So what type of editor is it that allows users to generate that type of content?
It's fairly similar to the editor in Forza 2. We've just made some improvements to it. So we support over 4,000 layers on the cars. It's kind of like Photoshop. If you understand how 2D paint packages work, you just layer these shapes on top of each other, and you can create just about anything, from basic race liveries to full photorealistic portraits of humans.
And as far as what's the big difference in the engine that the game is built on from 2 to 3?
Well, it's hard to say. Everything's new. We basically rewrote it from the ground up again for this version of the platform. Nothing really is the same. We're doing real-time rendering. We calculate SH on the car, real-time, global illumination. Tracks are rendered with new fidelity. There really is no similarity to Forza 2. It's all new.
So clearly, Xbox Live fans are all over this. Talk about some of the online functionality available.
Well, as I mentioned, the new storefront feature we're really excited about. It's going to bring communities together. You know, our ultimate vision for the online community is, think about it, we have people who are painters, guys who are tuners, guys who are great drivers, drifters, guys who can create great videos. Our goal is to bring all these people together. They have a common passion around cars, and they're going to work together in the community to create some disruptive content out there that we consume on Xbox Live. So we have a great drifter like Landon on our team from the Blackjack. Great painters out there. Guy puts a livery on a car, a guy tunes it to set up to drift right on this track. The drift driver comes in, does the driving, and then the replay editor guy, the WMV editor guy, comes in, takes the replay, creates a great video out of it. Now we've got this collaborative effort with people all over the world with unique skill sets that put together this truly creative content that none of them could have done by themselves.
So beyond just Xbox Live, you guys are also incorporating your website.
Yeah, ForzaMotorsport.net. It's kind of an extension of the Xbox Live experience now. So a lot of the same things that you can find on the storefront and leaderboards on Xbox Live, you can go over and find on ForzaMotorsport.net as well. And we'll be continuing to evolve that and create additional functionality for the website.
Cool. Well, you can find John in the Hello Kitty Ford GT. Thanks, John.
Thank you.